So I'm Rick Togashi from Mercury Inc. at Wesleyan University. This research was conducted under the supervision of Professor Tetsuya Sakai. Today I would like to talk about generalizing candle style for noisy and incomplete prefect judgments. So in the first, relevance is usually on a graded scale, highly relevant, relevant, non-relevant, and so on. What is the merit of graded relevance? If you want finer distinction among documents, then you should use graded relevance. You can handle an order like A over B over C. But creating graded relevant judgment is problematic because the burden on labels may be high, because multiple relevant grades make judgment complicated. The second reason is the difficulty in ensuring the quality of assessments. The scale of relevance grades may not agree among labels. Preference judgment can alleviate some of the problem. In preference judgment, labels decide which documents they prefer. Preference judgment allows for shorter time to answer for labels. Moreover, it gives a better inter-labeler agreement because the decision is binary. The drawback of preference judgment is the cost increase is quadratic to the size of SAC to be evaluated. There is a complementarity between preference judgment and crowdsourcing. Preference judgment can allow for collecting simple preferences, and simple preferences can be decided by non-expert workers. Crowdsourcing enables collecting data on a large scale while reducing cost, and it can alleviate the explosive increase of tasks for crowd workers. However, the remaining problems are that crowdsourced assessment may be noisy, and the quadratic order increase of tasks is still problematic for large-scale datasets. So in crowdsourcing, multiple preference labels for multiple labels from multiple labels are often available. It is essential to ensure the quality of data. And there are many aggregation methods for multiple preferences. In general, preference can be obtained as a probability. Methods of constructing preference probabilities from pairwise comparisons is, for example, majority voting, preference ratio, pairwise ranking aggregation. So here we propose a user model for labels. If we want to handle graded relevance, we can use preference judgment. Conversely, graded relevance implies transitive preferences. I prefer over J and J prefers over K, then I prefer over K. This is transitivity. To model it, we use the Bradley table model, quite simple, order statistical model. The winning probability that I prefer over J can be obtained as relevance of I divided by the sum of relevance of I and that of J. Then each decision of labeler can be considered as a Bellevue trial. Labeler's preferences is generated from Bellevue distribution with a winning probability. The difficulty of a decision for two documents is determined by the difference between relevance grade of them. Our proposed measure, eta, is based on Kendall's tau. Kendall's tau is a measure based on pairwise orders. The difference between the number of component pairs and that of discongruent pairs divided by the total number of pairs in the sum. By utilizing preference probabilities, the congruent pairs and discongruent pairs can be counted like this. The congruent pairs can be obtained as the sum of the congruent probabilities. If the system ranks I higher than J, then sum up the Pij, the probability that I is preferred over J. If the system ranks J higher than I, then sum up the Pji, the probability that J is preferred over I. Pretty simple. The discomfort pairs can be obtained as the sum of the discomfort probabilities. If the system ranks I higher than j, the sum of the pji, the probability that j is preferred over I. If the system ranks j higher than I, then sum of the pij, the probability that I is preferred over j. Then, by substituting soft-counted the number of concordant and discordant pairs for nc and nd in Kendall's tau, we can get eta measure. Delta ij is the difference of the indicator function. So, delta ij takes a value of 1 when I is ranked higher than j, if otherwise minus 1. This is an interpretation of the eta measure. The term 2pij minus 1 is a quite interesting term. The signature of this term is a preference level when thresholding is performed at the decision boundary p equal 0.5. The absolute value of this term is proportional to the distance from the decision boundary. This is the distance between the values of pij and pji. When the two values are close, in other words, when the preference is uncertain, the value is small. So if we use only a signature of this term, the eta measure is equivalent to Kendall's term. In the field of active learning, this term is used as a measure of uncertainty. Therefore, eta can be regarded as certainty weighted Kendall's term. We would like to explain another proposed measure. Pseudo-labeling is one approach to reduce the cost of evaluation on a large dataset. We can assign a predicted preferences to each document pair by machine learning techniques. With such methods, multiple preference probabilities rather than preference labels are available for each document pair. Moreover, several methods of machine learning, such as Bayesian inference and ensemble of multiple models, can handle the uncertainty of predictions. If we have the multiple predicted probabilities, such as the sample from the predicted posterior distribution, we can calculate the expectation and variance of them. By considering the uncertainty of predictions through the variance of probabilities, our proposal measure eta p can be obtained by like this. This is the experiment setting. Our experiments are conducted based on artificial data. Therefore, we can know the true relevance grade for each document. To verify our proposed measures, we investigate the agreement between our measure and Kendall's tau b using true relevance. We adopted the Pearson's correlation as the agreement between our measure and true tau b. First, we investigate the effect of the number of labels. Tau b degrades when the number of labels is small and even. This is because a lot of ties in tau b with majority body. There are a lot of ties in tau b because majority body. So we should hire an odd number of labels, but we cannot always ensure it due to exclusion of data from local delagans. Eta was quite robust in this experiment. Next, we investigated the effect of the number of abusers. We intentionally injected abusing preference, that is an oracle, but opposite to preference. Eta degrades more rapidly than tau b. This is because that eta tries to keep all information of bots, even from abusers. While tau b can suppress the abuse preferences by majority voting, this is a drawback of eta measure. Experiment 3 is a little bit complicated. Complete preference judgment are not always necessary to obtain the ideal ranking. We can infer unobserved preferences of dog pairs by using pairwise ranking aggregation. Based on observed bots, the likelihood of Bradley-Tate model is this. By applying MM algorithm, we can maximize this IPFOOD function. And the MM algorithm can be obtained at a fixed point iteration. Then we can obtain MLE of the winning probability by utilizing MLE of Lederman's U. We investigated the effect of the number of observed data. We compared three methods, tau b with MM algorithm and eta without MM algorithm, eta with MM algorithm. Even eta without MM algorithm outperformed eta tau b with MM algorithm. So eta and eta with MM are quite effective for incomplete judgments. So in this experiment, we compared the eta and the eta b measure. The figure shows the effect of the number of the probabilities for each document pair, or the number of the models for each document pair. The difference between eta and eta b is larger as the number of probabilities increases. So this y-axis is the difference of the correlation of eta and eta b. And eta b consistently outperform eta, even though the difference is small. That's it.